sing like heaven. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. Sun comes up, it's a new day. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may bless the Lord, oh my soul. Quick, fast testimony of my life and where I came before I knew Jesus. I'd like to mention that I give honor to my father and my mother. I love God with all my heart. Fifth commandment to honor your mother and father with okay, I got a story to tell you. I got a story to tell you about drugs. I'm talking about hardcore drugs like crack cocaine and cocaine. That kills. I'm gonna go into a big story here. I'm not gonna take up your time. Anyways, I'm against these hard drugs because I was addicted at one time in my life. But I overdosed and I came back. Praise the Lord for that. But my dad's 73 years old. God rest his soul. He died on a crack cocaine overdose at 4 o'clock in the morning. But prior to that, 10 days prior to that, he tried to get me to score for him. And I was like, no, I don't do those anymore. I have nothing to do with that no more. He punched me in the face. And I was like, whoa, you want to go? And I was going to fight him. But my mother was there. She was like, no, he's sick. He doesn't know what he's doing. So I turned around and I walked out the door. I said, I don't want to be responsible for you dying because you got a bad batch. I went there so many times and this guy smokes like $1,000 in the city. Like, it's crazy. It's retarded. Like, how the heck do you do this? And he says, I like it. I like it. It kills my pain. I said, that stuff will put you in the grave. Got mad at me because I wouldn't score for him. I took a shot in the face. It hurt so much, not the punch, but the action of him assaulting me. And I wanted to punch him right back because I was, you know, I wasn't saved yet at the moment. But you know what? After he passed away, I was like, Why would he leave like that? Give me a shot in the face and then go into the spirit world after, and then he overdosed on crack. Maybe that was meant to be, so I would hate that drug. Because that drug killed people I know. I know people that went to jail for a long time because of that drug. And now we got crystal meth. That's the worst. I put my foot down on this, and my parents would be proud of me to know that I'm stepping up against this crap. I hate this drug. This drug needs to go back to hell where it came from. Only God could do it, but we have to raise our hands and worship and really be sincere about this. This stuff is coming and ruining our lives, our children's lives. Like I said, I don't want my daughters growing up trying this drug and then becoming a prostitute or get apprehended by these bands driving around and kidnapping children. And it's happening. No word of a lie. I got a cousin that's been missing for over 11 years because of people like that. They deport those people back to their own country. They want to come here and be sleeper cells. Sleeper cell back in your own hood. This is our hood. And we're taking back this hood. In Jesus' name. Amen. And I drop all hate I had in the past towards anybody that come against me because that hinders my prayer life. So in Jesus' name, I lay it all before you, before God and all the witnesses of heavenly places right now, in the presence of the Lord, in the presence of you, in the presence of my own soul. I know I'm forgiven, I know I'm redeemed, and I know Jesus is alive. He's with me, for me, and he's always there. I just thank and I hold on to that promise because I know God is with me. I've been saved so many times in my life. I could have drowned in this river a couple times over as a child, thinking you can walk through this water. Anyways, I'm getting off topic here. I totally against the things that are going on into our city right now. We have a crystal meth epidemic, and with the help of ourselves to speak about it, to talk about it, to bring it forth, to warn our children so they don't get addicted to this and start prostituting themselves and start murdering for it. You know, we can't just sit back idly and not do nothing or say nothing about it. As a true follower and a believer of God, Christianity and Jesus Christ, we can't be silent. We're not saved to be silent. We should speak what the Spirit has to tell us. Like it says in Revelations, we have to let and warn everybody what's going on in this world. God's at the door. He's ready to come in. We have to usher him in. We gotta do these things so we can walk right, so our children can look at us and respect us, and then listen to the words we say, because we're not going to be here for very long. I'm going to be prepared, continuously prayer. Be ready, I'm at the door. Whoever has an ear, let them hear what the Spirit has to say to the church. The church is not a building. The church is us believers. We become a church, and we speak God's word through our life, through the way we live and the way we treat each other. If we don't love each other, then we're not truly who we say we are. To truly forgive and to let things go is to turn the other cheek and dust your feet off where you're at. People don't want to hear it. You know, they got to answer to God in the end. We all have to face judgment. And we're going to be sitting on that hot seat. And we're going to find out everything, even our thoughts, our deepest desires that are no good before God. So we have to live right, act right, talk right, think right, and believe right. So I'm going by Scripture, the New Testament, because he pours out his heart in all the Gospels. For Mark, John, Luke, Matthew, Romans, Ephesians, Revelations, all those ones. Meditate on the Word constantly, all the time. Lord, you are good. Make me short. You are great. You are above all things. You are in my life. You are in my mind. You are in my heart. You are in my soul, Lord. Don't ever leave. Be with me all the ways, all the days of my life, Lord. Behold, the old has passed and new has arrived. No more violence. in my life. Lord, bless me with all the good that you have, Lord. I trust you. I don't walk by sight, I walk by faith. I'm not blind to the Spirit. I understand who you are and why you're here. I like to explain to people that the true church is in your heart. You're either for him or you're against him. Jesus is the truth, the way, the light. No one comes to God except through the Father. There's only one way, and that's through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. He's worthy of all praises each and every day. He's going to get them all from me all my days of my life. I'm going to fight in the Spirit because that's where it's at. I believe and I trust in the Lord, and we ask and I give it to him.